Hello everyone, we are back with the letter. Okay, hi Leisha. Leisha was just wanted to have a little shake behind me. Hello everyone, before we start I am going to do the disable the warnings for the game, of course. In case you are watching it on YouTube, at least you know the warnings before we continue. So let me get the Steam up with the warning, because they have the page. Hello, Grey Wolf. So I'll read out, I think. Pause this sound effect on Steam. Okay, I'm gonna read out the warnings about this game first, and then we'll continue. It's always good. Hello, YouTube. Yes, yes. Make sure to say hi to YouTube. So, all the... the warnings before we start. it will show some scenes that some may find disturbing or triggering. It contains offensive language, racial slurs, sexual themes, gore, violence, and be warned by any triggers. But yes. Yeah, last time where we played it, last time we played it, Rose, our co-worker, our friend, died. She was on news, and we saw her not long ago, and she died in her room with help me, help me, help me. Yeah, we have, a picture of her. Is it this one? Can't find her. But we have a picture of her. She's somewhere. I don't know where the hidden things are. There's normally, a thing. Is it in extras? I think it's in extras. Oh yeah, there's a trailer. I never would have shown the trailer on the first episode, which, oops, my bad. Where is it? The letter credit. No, no! No! Did not mean to click that. There is a picture, I just don't know where it is, I'm blind. I think it's in Galleon, but it's not showing up. But yes, last time Rose died, she was on the news, and we kind of broke down, Isabella. But we are going to continue, and hopefully we find out how she died, and hopefully no one else dies. Is there something to save her? No. I don't think there's a way of saving her, sadly. Okay. At the moment, we have... became really good friends with everyone. Rebecca's a bit annoyed with us from last time because Ashton likes Isabella and Rebecca finds that annoying. But if anything, our friendship are going good in the game. We just don't know Luke and Hannah that much since they are new to people to her. Yeah, last time we saw a cat, the news about Rose. It's depressing. But anyway, we are going to continue. And hopefully no one else dies. I don't think there's a way of saving her. A buzzing sensation jots me awake. My body still wants to sleep. To forget what I heard. What I saw last night. But it's there nudging, prodding at me. Slowly I become aware of how awkward my position is. And the aches that accompany sleeping is a crawled up persistent the night before. Even if I slept at all, the memories are impossible to forget that Rose is gone. They say it's easier when you say it out loud. Instead, the words weigh heavier on me each time. She's gone. Gone because of me. Gone because of one letter I was too curious to look at. I should have been more careful. I should have just kept my mouth shut. I should have destroyed it before anyone else got involved. I should have. The notification lights up on my laptop and my laptop blinks in sensory mockery when I look at it as if it's calling me back to sense of normality. Oh. I check it nevertheless out of habit more than anything. Okay. To all BRC employments, in light of the recent end events, it will be all staff emergency meetings from 1 p.m. to 2 p.m. Attendance is a must. Company changes, new history, and possibly will all be discussed during the meetings. Everyone is expected to bring a copy of their own knowledge logs and sales support for the 6 months for submitting your graduate. We are expecting a one. Okay. If this were one of those typical days, I'll be happily comply and get myself to our office. Today my limbs just feel heavy. On one hand, going will keep me busy, take my mind off. Well, on the other hand, the place itself, it strokes reminds me of my own fears that have cost me. Go to work, stay home. Okay. I don't want her to lose her job. Because if she loses her job, then her friends are going to be more annoyed with her. She's not going to... I don't know. I think we're going to go to work. Because I feel like she might lose her job. Mopping won't get me anywhere. This is just one of those things, isn't it? You deal with it with a smile, no matter how bad things get, and hope for the best. Although my whole body feels like the limbs are sore, I push myself away from the chair and head for a shower. Plus, he needs to earn money. This is true. The letter I dropped on the floor last night flutters open as I pass by, unfolding for no one else but me to see. Every word written on it, it glares back at me. Housing is not cheap. Nope. They snur, they redeer. Like living being fully aware of what they're doing. With a huff, I pick it up and shove it in my bag, perhaps with more anger and frustration than I'm used to showing. This too, I'll deal with. Somehow, I'll find a way to make things right. I have to, before it takes more people from me. Even if I must do it on my own. Paper rustling, telephone ringing, feet shuffling. Overall, today looks like a typical working day at Reality Propitation. Except, it isn't. The air is thick with tension and unspoken questions. No doubt, everyone's present has already heard about Rose. If they missed last night's report, they'll likely see it in the morning news, in the papers, or on the various news sites on the internet. Everywhere is a bitter reminder. In fact, everyone's giving me a wide breath, as if the more mention of Rose would be even enough to trigger something in me. It's appreciated, but only serves to create a bigger hole in the place Rose has left. After lunch, my boss calls me for a meeting. I don't have to look up from my work to know what it's about. He's in a strange, pensive mood today, probably out of respect for a dead colleague. Oddly, I'll appreciate it more if he just shouted at me today. Anything is better.
I'm sure you've all heard of what happened to Miss Cooper. She was a valued member of our team and she will be missed.
By the way, if the game is too loud or too quiet, let me know. I'll make sure to fix that.
There's no date for a funeral yet, but those who wish to attend, kindly speak with your respective supervisors. By the way, has anyone heard about our still AWOL staff? None? HR, you know what to do. Santos, a word? In my office?
At the end of it, I've been given the interior of Rose's workload, including finalizing the right paper, and have been promised an an ample compensation for my efforts. I think he's expecting me to be happy about it. Instead, I amuse myself in my work. I have to anyway, if I want to forget. Time flies when you do what you do, and by the time I give notice, it's already late. Everyone's already gone, leaving me in the company of a radio and a member of our janitorial staff. I overworked her. Damn. Everyone's already gone. We read that. I don't even know his name. Rose likely does. He remembers the people easily like that.
The Lutzbomb Police Department continues its search for the following reported missing people.
This is sad. Yeah. It's fucking depressing. The radio bears one name after another. Hold on a second. Missing? Aren't they... Still, I have to check. Frantic, I turn back to my desktop. The loud tapping of my finger against the keys fills the office for a better part of my shift as I look through everything. The background about this place is history from the current owner and the list of employers hired under BRC. And I'm right. Of course I am. BRC may have a lot of staff. They may have a lot of ancient hired, but I remember those names anywhere. After all, they're also part of the crew who worked with us in preparing the mansion for the open house. Then the letters? No, that can't be. I hope it's not what I'm thinking.
But Rose is...
Something snaps into a place in the fraction of the moment. Those people. Rose. The letter.
I need to... No. If it's like this, they still won't believe me. I have to make sure of it first.
Evidence doesn't lie. That's what Ash often says, right? If I have proof, then maybe. I don't want to get my hopes up yet, but maybe there's still a way I can save them. The letter, my phone, paper, anything that will be useful. I grab them all and stuff them into my bag so there's a chance of Rose being alive. Okay. I can't stay here. There's something I need to do. There's something those people should. The noise cuts sharply through the room, stopping my hand short from cramming a pen into my bag.
Hello? Anyone there?
Rose could be alive! Rose! Someone must have left the printer open again. I may be in a hurry, but if I don't turn it off, another person is clearly going to have a fit tomorrow over wasted company researchers. Most of the time, it's Rose who does the nagging, but the clicking of my pen in my hand is welcome distraction as I search for the said object. Dancing a dinosaur. Each stride my feet takes as echo throughout the empty workplace. I lost sight of the janitor minutes ago, and with me being the only one left, the tapping of my feet against the wooden floor is something I soon learned to appreciate. It doesn't take me long to find it. By the time I turn it off, 5 pages are already strewed about the ground. I keep clicking it. Having it also been left ajar. Sighing, I picked each of it up and put some place proper. But the pages that greets me next makes my blood run cold. Oh, shit! The chill that makes it way up my spine as it's numbing. As the day in the attic, the streets crinkled under my tense grip. Organ hears my breathing as it rests through my gritted teeth. But before I could even gather myself, take the first step out of here, total darkness suddenly envelops me. Oh god. Oh fuck! No! And as if hearing every horrid thought running inside my head right now, something snaps. A soft creak grating through the thin veil of stillness that descended in the room. Every muscle, every bone in my body goes rigid at the sound. Familiar. So familiar now. Yet my own tenacious curiosity still presses me to take a careful peek over the cupboard wall. Why would you look? You fucking hide. You fucking leave. You leave the fucking building. Oh, nope. It's her. Nope. Nope. Oh, fuck. standing in the only exit of the office, a boat facing away from- Fuck! She doesn't even need to turn around for me to know it's the same misshaped face, tattered clothes, and unslightly the same person in the attic. I take a step back, the pen I'm holding slips from my hand and- Oh, fuck! Oh no, her entire head turns! Hi! What a pretty face you have! A scream almost escapes my mouth and I duck under the table as quickly as I can. My heart is pounding hard against my chest. I could hear a bone-chilling sound of her walk, the weird clicking that follows her, and the telltale squish of something wet as he walks towards me. Fuck. Nearer and nearer. The sounds are slowly getting louder. The only thing keeping me, the whimper from escaping me, is the hand is covered in my mouth. Someone please save me. Anyone. I close my eyes, muttering a consumption stream of prayers, all whilst attempting to steady my own breathing. Please, please don't let her hear me. Oh shit! Oh shit! I killed her! Oh no!
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Oh, you're dead!
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
She's dead.
Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Oh, she's Amen. Dead. When the last lines of my prayer has left me, all that remains is a hush. None of her footsteps nor the chilling sounds he makes. Only silence. Oh God! I don't want to click! I don't want to click! Is it safe? No! Another second passes and when nothing comes. What? Fuck! Punch the face! I killed her! Continue? Okay, they're letting me fucking save her. I thought that was just her dead. Okay, so she can't die. Okay. We're fucking saving her. We're saving her. Fuck. What? Yes! Oh my god. It's because she was praying, she was loud. The sounds minutes stretched out before analyzing. Is he gone? Slowly open my eyes and take a peek. I don't dare make a move or make a noise. Yes, she fucking prayed and that's what killed her because she was praying. Oh my god. Look at them feet. I did not miss them feet. In the face of such horror, I can only beg that our silent plea to whoever is out there. Please, please don't let her notice. I want to live. What the hell? Hannah! The fuck? Okay. We know she's not dead because we had to redo that. I'm sorry that I killed Isabella first try. Who is that? Hannah is on the right. So, profile. We have a new profile. So, we were playing Isabella, our first one. I think this is in line. So our next person is Hannah. Hannah is the Mrs. Wright. She is married to Luke. Isabella and Rose were... No. Isabella isn't dead. She was dead because we killed her by accident. But the game was like, it said, the game said, hey, redo that because you need her alive for now. So, Isabella is safe, I think. She's just in the office. Okay, we don't... This is all new. Is there anything interesting that we need to know? She likes dogs, fashion, parties, dancing, the beach, children, charity. Nice. Okay. So this, if you want to read this, pause here if you're on YouTube. Or what? I'm too lazy to read that. We got relationships. So, we are Hannah. This is her. Her husband. We are very good friends. And we don't know Ashton. We don't really like both of them. But I think this is even ground when you don't know someone. So, let's begin. We are with Hannah. Is it far too easy to get them to pay attention? Enraptured. Rich. Yep. They are rich. The rights. They hang out on every word and follow every move. All of it would have been stifling had I have not grown used to such stares. I'm going to try and give all of them voices, how I would give them a voice. So I'm going to make her a bit more posh. Most are respectful, some are hostile if we are honest, and a few are downright inappropriate. After all, I am.
Hannah Wright!
Hello. There's a moment of attraction as a familiar but less than welcome face approaches me with a suggestive smirk on his face. Of course I had to keep a behavioural smile and greet him as I greet my any good friend. After all, this man can turn heads, being famous in his own right.
Officer Lee!
Officer
what a pleasant surprise.
Oh, I skipped by accident. I guess we're having a dinner party. He is more Luke's friend than mine. Really, I am quite sure I only invited his wife. Much like I am only friends with the shift inspector because of Luke. Luke is only friends with Rosalie because of me. Unlike how I treated Lee, however, Luke never hid his emotionally for Lee Mottridge. It was an odd sort of friendship when we would have an awkward double date. I don't even recall his first name. It starts with an N, I think. I may be wrong. Aside from being chef, inspector of Lux Bronze Police, his wife Rosalie Lee Vance owns a general electrical company, fridges and freezer mostly.
Oh, I always have time for my favourite socialite couple. Might I say, you look positively ravishing tonight.
You don't give me a good tone, dude.
I see the husband isn't with you.
No, I don't like your voice. I'm sorry, I'm getting a bad vibe. The way he eyes me up is enough to make my skin crawl. Yep, thank you. I'm glad he get. You know what? That voice actor is doing a good job. Giving me the crawls. I just wish Luke is here to fend off the more unseemly of our peers. You know the ones. Men who are just too friendly, staring too long at my assets and getting close just because my husband isn't here. And to think they all have to gal to do this on my own party. In my own house, if I may add. But like any high socially woman, worth her salt, I know how to handle it with grace and dignity.
I suppose you are looking pleasant as well. Luke's busy with work, unfortunately. Michelle isn't here.
Shame. I do hope he isn't causing you much trouble. That husband of yours can be a bit daft sometimes, acting like he's still some young bachelor. The wife sends her regards and her apologies, but something came up with a doctor and she needed to attend to it.
I don't like the guy. He's a creep.
I
agree. He is a creep. I don't even like him. This is our first time meeting him. We make small talk. Rather, I'm forced to do so, as he would not leave my side after finding his place there. Much to my charging, I've been extracted from a few who flock in hopes of flattering, for I can tutelate them for far better than Lee. He is nice enough person. I do adore his wife, who is obviously the brains behind the two. But there is something unsettling about him. I do not trust him as much as I want to. He regales to me tales of Luxbrun's police department, a different affairs to usually gossip I am privy to, and though I love to admit it is interesting nonetheless. I expect the topic of business to die out quickly, which would be understandable enough due to the conflicting nature of his work. But oh boy, was I wrong.
So, we're in civvies, I steal and drive off with one of the police mobiles, right? In the mirror, I see the new tent chasing on foot and screaming about theft. The look on his face was priceless when I parked in the garage.
Oh my, you made him chase you all the way home for a prank. What did Rochelle have to say about that?
Rochelle has a strange love and hate affair with Lee. He is a married man who did not grow up past his early 20s, judging by the way he acts. Surprisingly enough, they've been married for a good 20 years. A lifetime if you compare it to my marriage of 7 years with Luke. I, on the other hand, while Luke is no Lee, I should be happy about that, I suppose. Although my darling did have his moments.
Yeah, the wife pulled my hair and gave me a good talking to, though. Besides, we live in a flat a block away, so it wasn't much of a grand chase.
Weren't you living in a house near the countryside?
Moved for work, you know. Or you probably don't.
No, I don't. But a flat in downtown. I suppose.
Oh, it's
oh, I keep clicking.
A tiny place, no matter how convenient it can be for work. 55 square yards are not enough when you need to get away from the wife. I wouldn't mind a place away from the city. Even started looking at the ads. I spied an interesting lot, actually. Heard it was finally put up for sale. Or that something mansion, you know the one with all the ghost stories.
I know what he's talking about. There are really only a few unbanned legends around there. It's...
the Ermagood Mansion?
That's the one. Worthy of a king it is. I'd buy it myself, but Rochelle would only gripe if I brought it up to her.
Okay, I think this is before they bought the... they went to the open house, so I think this is before.
Not to mention all the expenses, a place like that. It'll be a real fixer-upper. You also have to find someone willing to work there with how superstitious people can be.
If it becomes a problem, just hire someone to do an exorcism.
Actually, I do know of someone who could be up to the task.
Oh my god.
You remember the Ludgates party at their Christchurch summer residence?
Of course. It was an excellent soiree. Everything was so classy too. Such good taste.
Oh, that place was a pigsty until they hired out this interior designer and they turned it into a bloody palace.
Okay, and this is how she finds out about, Marina. This is how she finds out about her.
Okay. She worked for the Exodus for their apartment in Soho too, and they recommended her when we were looking up pieces for our beach house in Porto Colom. I think I have a business card right at... No, must have left it in my other jacket. Anyway, she's called, Marianne, I believe, yes.
All right, Marianne.
But truly, if anyone were to get that place in McCullough, well, they'd be the envy and the talk of the town.
And that's why Hannah wants that.
Well, if you put it that way, I might just snatch it up for myself. This place was starting to feel a bit small lately anyway.
Sure, a three-story penthouse might not fit the detention of small for some people. Okay, maybe a lot of people, but it isn't big enough to have a grand party in. As it is, I only invited only 30 people to this one, and it already feels cramped in here. It certainly would be nice if I didn't have to ride an elevator up and down 7 floors before I can get anywhere as well. All Luke's words, not mine. Besides, I have been looking for a good anniversary gift. Luke might like this one. Where is he anyway? Okay. So that explains why they went for the house. Luke is dressed in to the nines as usually, and he's looking ready to for whatever the day will throw at. I am going to try and kill this fucker. Not gonna lie, I am gonna kill this fucker. How dare he not be polite to what's his name, Zach? Fuck you. His butler, Violet, waits at his side, just in case he isn't ready to look. The blonde kid reminds me of someone. Oh yeah? I wonder who. Oh sure, that is normal. What's confusing me is the fact that he is on his way of the penthouse, and consider we won't have anywhere to go until much later.
Where are you going?
I am to attend the Triad Autumn Tasting. I do believe I informed you of this 2 weeks ago.
We have timeline. Okay. So this is when we started with Isabella. So we are 2 days earlier. Okay. Someone from Grammarly Fall, that's the little child. Oh my god. I know who you're talking about. The fucking guy with the book. He's tiny. He goes with Mabel. Gipsy or whatever. Wait, no, that kid had white hair. Yeah, but I know who you're talking about. Okay.
Yes. And might I remind you that I had stricken that off your schedule? Because one, the doctor told you to stop consuming so much alcohol.
Oh, he's an alcoholic.
And two, I informed you a few days ago about the open house we were going to attend in its place. I've even found this marvelous interior designer, Mary Ann McCullough.
Mary Ann,
it's a 3.5-hour drive to Cardiff. I don't have time for this.
You don't have time for anything.
This is like that little party you threw all over again.
Oh,
don't
inform my beer
me of it,
drinker.
And you expect me to stay and be a gracious host when I have business elsewhere.
Well, lucky woman she is. So you got a husband that drinks and
you know
is
how
a
I
racist.
Operate, Hannah. Unless this was penciled in, I am sticking to my schedule.
Oh yeah, Luke is racist.
The madam is correct.
That's why
your
I don't like him.
Your physician did insist you moderate your drinking. Unless you wish to incur acute pancreatitis. And you did have this open house penciled in last Wednesday morning.
Bullocks! I don't remember doing so!
Well, you did. While very hungover, in fact.
Yep. Fucking drinker. He did. Moaned about me being too loud, but gave in after some pushing. Perhaps that was a bit too cruel and manipulative of me, but...
What side are you on?
Come
my
on,
side.
Luke. You promised we'd do whatever I want this weekend.
Gordon Bennett, fine. I am giving this house tour yours a chance.
Yeah.
But if it proves to be a waste of time, I am going to Cardiff and you are going to take a cab home.
You are a bitch.
Are we clear?
You are a bitch. It's just a bit of a husband and wife tit and tat, isn't it? All couples have their arguments. Dump the bitch. Once the honeymoon phase is over, as they seem to call it, reality sets in, and you and your partner might not always see eye to eye. Perhaps it has been the years. 7 of them, nothing to scoff at. I feel like the game won't let you kill Luke. I will be so sad if they don't let me kill Luke.
I just cannot bloody believe I agreed
to
this.
I don't like him.
I was really looking forward to the Triad tasting.
Though sometimes I think it's something a bit more than just a simple disagreement, and I have to stop myself from wondering where we went wrong.
There's always the Triad Christmas tasting in Manchester next month, and that'll only be an hour and a half drive.
Have I been neglectful? Have I been offended? Have I acted shamefully?
Yes, but God,
I don't know if he thinks it's her fault. Certainly, any problem can be discussed. As long as he doesn't turn me away.
Well, there goes my good mood. Are you happy now, Hannah?
I hate you. Remain silent. Defend myself! You know what? Defend
yes,
myself!
I am
Fuck
very
you.
Happy, Luke. Because for once in a very long time, we are doing what
wait,
I want.
Wait. He liked that? Wait, give me a moment. I wanted to defend myself for the bitch to back off. He liked that. What? He liked me being like, bitch, fuck off. What the fuck? Okay. I'm very shocked by that.
I'm ecstatic. Understood? And this would be perfect if you stop acting like a child who needs their nappy changed.
Oh my god, I call him a baby, and he's like, I'm into
we
it.
We will be leaving after lunch for the Ermengarde Mansion. You are going to park your rear in the car and keep mum. And you are going to behave during the tour.
Oh my god, he likes being told what to do. Needless to say, Luke looks a bit shocked at my little outburst. Oh no. He likes being bossed around. Oh, I wanted him to dislike me. He opened and closed his mouth a few more times, struggling to reply. But before he crosses his arms to look like, well, a mopping child.
Any more rules for this little excursion of yours, Your Highness?
Oh my god, he likes it. He wants more rules.
No wine.
Oh.
No wine.
Oh my god.
Unacceptable. I am already not allowed to the tasting, and you would deprive me of that simple pleasure.
Yes. No wine.
If
oh my god, they even have a wine
pitcher. Today, I will put the stocks under lock and key. Do you understand me?
To the cell he goes.
Don't forget the bottles he keeps in his dresser.
Oh my god, thank you.
Whose side are you on?
Yes.
How many times in one day can you ask that?
9 times a day.
As many times as I need you, traitor.
He liked it. The ride to the mansion is quiet, with Luke having stared out the window the entire way, not paying attention to anything around him. Meanwhile, I am conflicted. I don't know if I should say sorry for changing his plans like that. By the time we arrive at the mansion, I see his eyes light up in a general interest. Sorry is the last thing that is on my mind. The whole affair is the Ermengarde Grand Mansion is clearly an interesting experience. The place had been renovated and restored by the owners to what they claim to be acceptable standard. The mansion itself looks like something befitting to a fairy tale or a period piece. It is tastefully decorated, and with a little bit of love and attention, I'm sure it can be a place that Luke and I can call home. And the number of our prospective buyers that have come from the powerful and wealthy of the Lux Bonds certainly did not disappoint, marking this estate as a prime property. The Lees are amongst the groups who went with the Rose Woman. I saw a few others notable faces, though. I did not really feel like mingling. Unfortunately, for every one of them, the Wrights are interested in buying. Okay. Wheel and woo. What's been bugging my mind, however, is that Isabella. What is her problem? I still don't quite understand what is happening. One moment she's scrambling to give us the paperwork to finalize the sale, and then she's panicking over some sort of prank letter to another.
Dear me, is Isabella all right?
It is a punchin with every way she shakes, and by the pallor of her skin, something has really shaken her up.
Isabella, do you need me to call that ambulance?
Oh my god, Rose, we miss you. I'm worried, but I will be best if she attends to by someone more familiar to her, like her partner. But even then, the girl refuses Rose's offer, drinks, and looks about ready to make a run for it. Isabella!
No, I'm just feeling a bit out of it. Excuse me, I'll be back. I just need to catch my breath.
And she does so, just as predicted, and her partner follows like a concerned mother. There's an awkward air among us as we are left in a wake of whatever that was. The other mumble and gossip with each other, speaking of the poor jaffed girl telling the tale of whoever was not audience to the act in the first place. Mother! Rose's mother, dearest. Confirmed. It doesn't take too long for the woman Rose to return and pull us aside to a study for what I rightfully assume is damage control. Rose invites Marina in too, hoping to say sorry to her as well. But the woman refuses, saying she is not the one who of her clients anyway. That leaves myself, Rose, and Luke, the last all too eager to make himself comfortable in a study he's no doubt already claimed as his own.
I can't apologize enough about what just happened. Please forgive Isabella. She's been under a lot of pressure lately. She's young and all those rumors about this being haunted just got to her head. And it must be this terrible heat, too. Not a drop of rain for days now.
Are you sure it is wise to just let her go like that?
Yeah.
Where is the poor dear? She might get hurt.
She's more likely to hurt somebody else, given what just happened.
I told her to sit down and take a break. Already rang someone to pick her up, too.
That might be for the best, dear. But please, we're here to talk about the mansion, yes? Why, I absolutely adore it! Don't you, Luke? Some of the rooms will certainly have to be repurposed. We want to change the appliances and have Marianne lead on the decor, but the whole thing is just lovely.
I guess. It's certainly a lot roomier than our penthouse.
Exactly! Lots of space for guests, parties, a lot of room for little ones to run around too.
Oh my gosh, she wants kids.
Let's not discuss that right now, Buttercup.
And he's like, fuck, I don't like kids.
Anyway, I do think it would be a shame to let this mansion slip past us.
She wants kids and he's like, no.
But you haven't even finished touring the house.
Well, we like what we've seen.
Kids! I am making her job easier for her, am I not? No need for loans or long prices and notifications. We can just sign the contract and close the deal. Really, you think this woman would be more happy about an easy sale? I know how those Esther agent work, how long they have to wait, and how much they had to spend even just for a single sale. Why she should be jumping for joy by now? I'm sure the commotion of this mansion is nothing to sneeze about, even if she has to split it with the Isabella girl. Huh,
do you think we could have horses here?
Yes, those do sound nice, love.
Oh, she's done with his shit.
Anyway, if anyone else is interested in buying this property, I assure you that I'm able and willing to give a better offer.
A vineyard would be nice.
Oh my god.
Or maybe a...
And we do reward our people quite generously, Rose. So if I were you, I would start on that paperwork.
Helicopter pad.
Oh my god. I pause. And there's a smaller moment of a complete silence when Rose and I just stare incredulously at Luke. Yep. It is an unspoken understanding, a rule between the two of us that we have to put on an act. With our social standing, where image matters, it's also important to avoid making enemies. And to follow this rule is an easy feat for me. From youth, I have been the well-trained social butterfly, gracious and graceful. Luke, on the other hand.
Wait, what, Luke? No, what? Whatever would we need a helipad for?
Well, he likes to play the fool sometimes, even if he is anything but. As he throws me a wary smile, I shake my head and beckon Rose over. This is to be our home, and there is nothing she or anyone else can do to change my mind. This is a place that speaks of power and importances, and at the same time, of a safety, of a comfort. Perhaps we can even have our family here. Yes, he wants kids. There is definitely no better gift from our own special date. Why, everything here is opportunely wonderful. Except for this ugly painting in the study. I don't think this is a painting, hon. It looks like a bad fake of an Edvard Munch painting.
Here's the deal. I'm willing to pay 10% higher than your listing price.
You're just gonna walk past that?
If anyone tries to outbid us, just add another 5%. I doubt anyone can, of course. Or, you know what?
Looks just like a mirror, I agree.
15% to the listing price, and we can sign all the paperwork now.
I guess, if that's what you want. That won't be any trouble. I don't have all the papers now. Didn't think this would be a quick sell. I'll have copies sent to you so you can look over them. And if you'd still like to finish the rest of the tour with Isabella's group, you're more than welcome to.
No, I think we're good here. We'd appreciate a private tour of the place a lot more, I think.
All right. Should I let Marianne in, then?
Marianne? All right, she's been waiting outside the study this whole time, hasn't she? I need to have a little chat with her to move this little mansion project forward.
Please do.
There's a look of apprehension when the other woman enters the study. Yet, like a professional, I see the moments when she steals herself and make her worry admirable.
We have this project then?
Of course. Will you?
Having the floor plans would be a great start, just so that I can look at them beforehand. And if you could tell me when you're available for a meeting so that I can include it in my calendar?
Oh, is a meeting really all that necessary, Marianne? I guess we can send Johannes to help you out. You two can start by getting rid of this ugly painting.
A hush falls upon the room as my request.
What painting?
It was a mirror! It was a mirror! And look and behold, the painting is gone. In its place, a mirror stands, which leaves me to look at my own confused expression.
Odd. Well, no matter. Back to the topic at hand.
Oh yeah, just walk.
Marianne, dear.
Okay.
You're simply far too busy to meet up.
Okay. The bitch was like, ah yes, there was a demon girl in my mirror, but anyway, I will not have this house. Moving on. Free of my scratcher, question the need for a meeting. Oh. Perhaps maybe I should free up my schedule, question the need for a meeting. Oh, and what was this about? I forgot. Can I look at the log? Backlog. Back to the topic of hand, Marianne dear, we are suddenly far too busy to meet up. Or perhaps maybe I should. Okay. Free up my schedule, question the need for. Question the meeting, yeah. Did you save? No. I see, didn't like that. What I'm trying to do is, I save now and then, but all the options I do pick, I'm keeping, unless the game actually tells me, like I did with Isabella, of, hey, you made this choice, and you killed her, redo it. But if the game does make me kill someone and it was based by a choice, I am not going to go back. I'm keeping this is my first playthrough, so I'm not changing anything if a choice happens and the game doesn't tell me to redo it. So hopefully I pick the right choices. This is the first slurs we acquired, of course. Yeah. This is why choices matter. Because you never know. One choice, yeah, someone might die or something bad might happen. But that choice, that's a choice that I have made. It's in the game for a reason. I'm going to make it. Hopefully it's not a bad choice that I make. So, hopefully it will go good and no one dies again. We brought plenty of others from penthouses in Luxburnt to a vacation townhouses in nearby cities. It is, however, the first time that an interior designer has asked for a meeting with me. Normally, I'll just let them do as they please and hope for the best. I found that they rather like the creative freedom it lends them. They all bragged about it. Hannah Wright is a living in this house I designed.
I can make time, but I'm sure you're more than capable enough to work on your own, yes?
Was it more of C saying, work on your own then? Oh, fuck.
Surely I would just get in the way and you can do things faster and more efficiently without my input. Because, no offense, if you're one of those workers who need constant supervision and hand-holding, You might as well tell me now so that I can look for another interior designer to work with.
Surely this one will feel the same?
Yes. I am capable of working without any design input and without supervision, Mrs. Wright. But it'd be entirely different if I know what you two would want for this home, how each room is meant to be used. You have to consider what sort of color palette you would want, at the very least.
Yeah, I feel bad. I should have made space in my timetable.
Do consider that this will be your home and not mine.
None of those houses ever did feel like home.
You won't give me a choice in the matter, will you?
What? No. You do have a choice, and...
No. You've clearly made up your mind that we must meet. All right. Monday. 10 o'clock
sharp.
Okay,
we do meet up anyway. Okay.
We'll see you then.
Actually, Mary Ann suggested that we meet at 9, but who is even awake at that unholy hour, crazy people? I was lucky enough to wake up this morning before Luke went all the way to Cardfield. We say our goodbye and shake hands and make it clear without outright saying it that we now own this house. By the time we left the mansion grounds, sunset is almost upon us.
So, you really want to buy this place then? That's a bit of a big impulse buy, even coming from you. Not that I'm complaining.
I feel electric when I hear those words from him. It's not every day one is able to please someone like Luke. He gives away false flattery to sway those who starve for his attention and approval. But in a privacy of closed door, he opens often express his griffiness. He neither console himself in front of me, nor spread me from his criticism.
You have been saying the penthouse was getting a bit too small for you. Happy anniversary!
Oh. That time of the year already?
Oh my god, this bitch. He forgot about it last year too. I understand that he's a busy man,
but... Is that why you want to buy it?
Yes. You don't like it?
I do, but I remember you used to talk about how you wanted to live next to the beach.
Bruntley Bay, Kent. I remember the sea, water, the stretch of the miles and miles, as far as the eyes can see. As a kid, I loved our beach trips, swimming all day as much as I could. I was a well-behaved child, and only time I was ever truly difficult was when I refused to get out of the water, even when my fingers have gone all wrinkly. And even when they managed to pull me out of the water, there was always sandcastles. The day before we married, I told Luke that I wanted a house on the beach and a dog. And a kid or two. None of those came true 7 years later.
That was a childish dream. Living next to the beach is so impractical if you really think about it.
I don't know. It's not a bad thought to see you in a bathing suit every day.
Oh, wow.
Maybe another time, love. We still have forever, don't we?
He says nothing, only grabbing my hand and holding it tight as we spend the rest of the ride back home in silence. My kids, after all what happened. I don't know. Because he wants kids ever since they got married. I miss the sea. Sick and hovering over the loo is free in the morning. The picture I paint right now is hardly glamorous. A horrifying fishing taste is left in my mouth as I throw up from what I had for dinner. I hate the acid stench that fills the lavatory. The burning sensation in the back of my throat is no help whatsoever. I can feel another wave of nonchalance comes up from me when the door opens.
Hannah, what are you doing so early out of bed?
Wait, she's throwing up. Is he pregnant?
I'm fine, love. I must have just eaten something bad.
That's all I can manage to say before vomiting again into a potion throne. Lovely. I think she's pregnant.
Just go back to bed, Luke. I'm going to clean up here.
I refuse to look at him. I don't want him to see me like this. The last thing I had a horrible morning. Wrenching into a toilet was during my college year, being the life of the party. Thoughtless and shameless, I had thrown away months of arcane and pointless hookups. I didn't even retain any of my connection I had made from the time. Oh god, she is pregnant! Oh god! Oh, she drank too much. I think she's pregnant. not gonna lie. She is hinting kids. He doesn't want kids. But hey, if she dies, then there's two people that die. Surely they still know me, and I still know of them, and I still do business from time to time. But I've lost touch with anyone who I didn't see it on a daily basis. Oh God, I hardly have any of my friends I had when I was still Hannah Evans, teacher, fellow university student, drinking buddies, and an old country like Jack. JP, no.
No, don't touch me, sweetie. It's disgusting.
Okay, Luke. You are a supportive husband. That is sweet.
I'm disgusting.
No, you're not. Luke sits down next to me on the toilet floor to hold my hair, as I cough up more fish. Oh, so it is fish. She might not be pregnant, just fish. He wipes the vomit from the corner of my mouth and just stares.
Do I need to fire someone? I don't feel sick.
Or she is pregnant. I don't know.
Just feeling a bit under the weather, dear. It's been unbearably hot as of late, hasn't it? I do wish it would rain.
Are you sure it wasn't those sweets?
They seem like a lovely couple.
Not to eat those sweets.
they seem so lovely. But I don't know. When I first met them, they were a bit snobby. And then Luke just went downhill when he said the N-word to Zach. But this is cute. I will admit, this is cute. He's supporting.
Maybe. Well, don't laugh.
Well, I can't help if you make that sort of face.
He starts chuckling, and soon enough, he's in a fit of laughter. The scene happens next to the loo, filled with sick, just makes the whole thing bizarre, and it nearly makes me start giggling as well. I try to still free it for it, though, as I smack him on the shoulder.
I'm not making a face, Luke. Stop laughing.
When he would not stop laughing, I let myself go as a laughter bubbles from my own throat, and I forgot whatever I am feeling clothed me. We are just husband and wife laughing together at a funny face, the little things in life. I let myself go because I know that those moments will never not last forever. Is it bad if they are going to die? Yeah. It would be very sad if they die now. But if I just know the terrible things that are to come to us, I would have wished this with everything I have then and now, the laughter stayed. Aww.
Up, higher. Come on now.
Okay. I think I'm going to end the stream here. I think this is a good spot to end it on a cute note and not no one dying and me having a heart attack. Tomorrow I will post the next week's stream. Yeah, it's okay, Wool. Tomorrow I'll be posting on Discord the week's schedule. This will be sent on YouTube as well, on community. But yes, I hope you have enjoyed. Until next time, I shall see you then. Goodbye.